to authoring tool or not to authoring tool? A question learning designers often ask. So stick around for this video as I do an authoring tool review on Articulate Rise 360. Hi, Bianca Raby here, learning designer, CEO, and recovering anti-authoring tool club leader. Yes, seriously, until this year I wasn't really a fan, but since my team at OPETA and I have used Articulate Rise 360 several times, I'm sold. So if an authoring tool is the right move for your development, we favour this one right now. So let's start with the most awesome things about Articulate Rise 360. Number one, stylish by default. With minimal input from users, Rise courses are easy on the eye. This also makes them quicker to build as many of the basic design elements are built into the system. For example, bullet points come with pre-designed or predetermined indents. Rise is also easy to brand. You can do different theme options, custom colors and fonts, different navigation, headers and menu options, and custom spacings. Number two, native block style. Rise knows how learning designers approach a learning experience and is built in the common learning blocks that we use. See the notes below for a link to a downloadable free Rise block library guide. Number three, responsive and compliant. Rise works great on all devices, and it even allows for designers to check what it looks like on different devices, such as desktops, mobile, and tablets. Articulate Rise has all of the same export technical standards of Storyline, including SCORM 1.2, SCORM 2004, AICC, and XAPI Tin Can. Number four, easy to share and duplicate. It takes just a click of a button to create and open a share link to show clients your progress. No logins needed. It's also super easy to duplicate modules and whole courses. Okay, so here are a few not so awesome things about Articulate Rise 360. Number one, costs. At over $1,000 Australian per year for a single user, it can be expensive for new learning designers, and they won't let you pay monthly. If you start working for a client that uses Rise, they will give you access, but this doesn't allow you to practice on your own terms. Number two, limits to customization. Since it builds in many of its design elements, it's not a blank canvas, like our favorite LMS canvas really is. Check out my LMS review here for more on that. Experienced learning designers may feel bound by Rise's native designs. Number three, assessment feature is basic. Articulate Rise 360 has limited ways for you to evaluate your learners. The multiple choice function they do have is also quite basic. At OPETA, we tend to rely on the platform or LMS we are embedding the course content into to evaluate. So what do you think? Have I missed anything awesome or not so awesome? Drop your comments below and let me know. If you've enjoyed this video, please click like and subscribe to this channel. It would really help. And check out this video on the rationale for using an authoring tool versus a natively building into an LMS or platform. And finally, join OPETA's Learning Design Rocks community to meet and network with other teachers and LDs. Thanks for watching, and until next time, stay awesome.